While appearing before Parliament's Human Rights Committee to respond to concerns raised by Parliament about the rampant torture and missing persons attributed to security forces, the chairperson of the Uganda Human Rights Commission, Mariam Wangadia, told MPs that the commission has no funds to investigate cases of human rights violations since July 2021, when the government clamped down on Democratic Governance Facility, which was funding the activities.
During the period under review, the commission did not conduct any tribunal hearings due to lack of the requisite quorum. Article 51 of the Constitution provides that the Commission shall comprise of the chairperson and at least three members. This means that even if the Commission had conclusively investigated some complaints, they could not be heard by the tribunal, as there was no.
The revelation left committee members in shock, wondering why government has not treated the commission as a priority to allocate it enough funds directly from the consolidated funds instead of leaving it to donor funders.
I don't know whether it was a misstatement, but really it shows that almost a whole year nothing has been done. So we want to know what is the problem and what about money. The commission has some people, the commissioners who are already working. At least some work should be going on. As my colleague stated it at the analysis stage, that we should see things moving on and we see where the gap is. We are working, we know there's that problem of money, and as an institution, as the government, is also working to see how it can fund.
External funding for the operations of Uganda Human Rights Commission. Isn't the Uganda Human Rights Commission a statutory body which has a first call on the consolidated fund? All statutory bodies have a first call on their budget. So why should they rely on external funding like this DGF fund? How about dealing through the jail law sector, justice law and other sector? Because that's again another critical area where funding is negotiated.
First of all, they should bring the budgets to the committee, we approve. Then if they don't bring their budget here to approve, now why are they saying they don't have money? They are not working.
The Human Rights Commission also revealed that seven Ugandans went missing in the hands of security agencies and their whereabouts have not been established for over 2 years now.
With that little, Mr. Chair, I want it to be on record. We are using that, and then the month we do that, we handle the cause list monthly, and the cause list for the month of April will be coming up shortly. So that means in the month of January, February, where we had our fellow colleague before passing on and expire of our other colleague, we handled 123 cases, and whereby we are missing out on some other commissioners. We are handling 87 cases in the month of March. We always handle over 100 cases monthly. Over 100 cases monthly, Mr. Chair. I want that to be on record.
The commission received 71 complaints of missing persons, but 64 were released by security agencies after different interventions. From January 2020, the commission has registered and investigated 443 complaints of torture, but only concluded 151 cases.
We registered and investigated 443 complaints of alleged violation of the right to freedom from torture. The Commission's Soroti Regional Office registered the highest number of complaints involving allegations of torture, 112 in number.
But in this era, we can report people missing. Are these things that concern you? Are these things you want to invest yourselves into? When you discuss with the police and the army, where is the problem? Is it us, the Ugandans, that we should change? Is the problem with these security agencies as an organ mandated to do the investigation and oversight on human rights? I just want to understand what your findings or how you relate with these groups and what they tell you about us.
The Human Rights Committee of Parliament, which was tasked by Parliament to probe cases of torture, arbitrary arrests and missing persons across the country, has challenged the Commission officials to initiate investigations into violations of human rights without waiting to receive complaints first. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.